Good morning and welcome to Sunday Worship Service with Wilmington Christian Center Church Worldwide. We are excited about the message you will hear today. So we thank God in advance for all of the manifestations in your life from the word spoken and believed. Many times we as believers are challenged with troubles on every side, but because of God's love, power, and his word, we see victory. So today we call you blessed in all things. As you listen to the word today, use your faith to turn your situation around to God's glory. So now prepare your heart to hear from the Heavenly Father as we begin with today's prayer and praise and worship, and then today's message from Pastor Phil. Have a blessed day.
Amen, amen, amen. You know, Psalms 145:3 reads, "The Lord is great, and he's greatly to be praised." So we're going to take this opportunity to lift up the name of Jesus. Father God, we just thank you. We praise you, Father God. You're awesome, Father God. You're a Lord of Lords, a King of Kings. And we just bless your holy name. We say hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory to your holy name, Father God, for you are really worthy, truly worthy to be praised, Father God. And Father God, we just thank you. We thank you that you counted us worthy to wake us up this morning, Father God. We thank you that you just kept us when we didn't even have a mind to be kept, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for this is a day that you have made. We can rejoice and be glad in it, Father God. We thank you. We thank you for the love that you bestow on each and every one of us, Father God. We just thank you. We glorify you. We honor you, lift you up, Father God, for there is not one like you, Father God. We thank you. We thank you for all that you do, all that you've done, and all that you're going to do, Father God. And Father God, we thank you for our pastor. We lift him up before you right now in the name of Jesus. We thank you that the things that you've entrusted to him, that they will come forth today in the name of Jesus. We thank you that what comes across today will come across in clarity, Father God, so that your people will hear what you're saying to them. But I ask that you open up their eyes, Father God, so that they'll see what's coming to them in the word, Father God. Open up their ears, Father God, so that they'll hear, Father God. But Father God, open up their hearts so that they'll receive what you have for them today in this word, and that they will get a rhema word from you, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, we just lift up our pastor. We thank you. We plead the blood of Jesus over his life, Father God, that no harm or danger will come near him or his household, Father God. And Father God, as we go forth, we thank you for our praise team, Father God, that as they come forth, they'll continue to usher us in the name of Jesus into your presence, Father God. But we just take this opportunity to love on you, Father God. We adore you. We magnify you. You are Lord of Lords again, Father God, and King of Kings. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you, Father God. We just thank you, thank you, thank you. And we give you all the glory. And we pray that you'll get all the honor out of this service right now in the name of Jesus as we go forth. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen, amen, hallelujah, glory to God. We praise and worship our Lord and our Savior. And we give him, take this time out to go ahead and prepare our hearts to receive this word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A lot of things been going on, but let's focus in on him, our Lord and our God. We have biblical solutions for us today. Hallelujah, Holy Father, we thank you right now. Hallelujah, our Redeemer, our Sustainer, Author and Finisher of our faith. Right now, we call upon the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Worship with me now. Now God is fighting for us. God is on our side. He has overcome. Yes, he has overcome. So we will not be shaken. We will not be moved. Because Jesus, you are here. He's carrying our burdens, covering our shame. He has overcome, yes, he has overcome. We will not be shaken, we will not be moved. Why? Because Jesus, you are right here with us. Hallelujah. So I will live, I will not die. The resurrection power of Christ is alive in me, and I am free in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Come on, get expectant about what God's going to do for you on this day, and with how this word can transform your thinking, transform your life. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on, put your trust in Him right now. Because He's carrying our burdens, covering our shame. He has overcome, yes, He has overcome. So we will not be shaken, we will not be moved. For Jesus, You are here. Woo! So I will live, I will not die. The resurrection power of Christ is alive in me, and I am free in Jesus' name. You want to say that again? So I will live, I will not die, I will declare and lift You high, that Christ is revealed and I am healed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now let's go in for a second and get this war cry. Get your war cry on. Get your war cry. Get your war cry on. Get your war cry. Get your war cry on. Why? Because God is fighting for us. Fighting for us. God is fighting for us. He's fighting for it. Here it is. God is fighting for us. Pushing back the darkness, fighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. In the name of Jesus, enemies defeated, and we will shout it out, come on. God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, fighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. So in the name of Jesus, enemies defeated, will shout it out, so I will live, I will live, yes, I will live, I will live, yes, I will live, I will live, yes, and not die. Woo! I will live, I will not die, I will declare and live Him high, that Christ revealed, and I am healed in Jesus' name. One more time, say that. I will live, I will not die, I will declare and lift You high, that Christ revealed, and I am healed in Jesus' name. Name, there's power in that name, there's power in that name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. So in the name of Jesus, the enemies are defeated, and we will shout it out. Shout it out. Y'all say it with me. God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. In the name of Jesus, enemies defeated, and we will shout it out, here we go. Say, God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. So in the name of Jesus, enemies defeated, and we will shout it out one more time. God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. So in the name of Jesus, the enemy's defeated, and we will shout it out, hallelujah, hallelujah. Shout for victory, shout because you've been set free. Glory to God. We shout for Jesus, hallelujah, yes, yes, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
shout it out. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Brother Jay, that was awesome.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
that I might do your will. And Lord, give me knowledge that I may know your word. Teach me to know your will and your way, that I might serve you better each and every day. Lord, give me wisdom so that I might serve you well. Lord, give me patience to wait on you. And while I'm waiting, dear God, help me to accept the truth. Oh Lord, teach me to know your will and your way, that I might serve you better each and every day. Oh Lord, give me wisdom so that I might serve you well. I wanna serve you well. I wanna serve you well. Oh, it's my heart's desire. I wanna serve you well. Oh, I wanna serve you well. Dear Lord, I wanna serve you well, oh Lord. Yes, it is, that I might serve you well. Oh Lord, it's my heart's desire, my good God. Oh Lord, my desire, so that I wanna serve you how I desire to serve you well. Lord, I want to serve you well. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Lord.
Thank you today. Glory be to God. Oh, that's powerful today, listening to that word and that praise and worship. Are you ready for the word? Glory be to God. You should be ready for the word today. Open up your Bibles to John 5. We're going to get right into the word. Glory be to God. John 5. Glory be to God. John the 5th chapter. We're going to look at verses 1 through 5. And before we do, we'll pray. Oh, praise God. Praise God. All right. Praise God. I apologize to you for that. We had a little technical difficulty. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let's look at John 5. And we're going to look at verses 1 through 5. You know, we've been looking, you know, we're 6 months into a new year. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, if you notice, in this year, we've been attacked with lack, sickness, disease. I mean, war between races, and as well as other issues. This has been an interesting year thus far, and we need to know what God has in store for us these next years. It's the most important thing that we have in understanding that, because we're in 6 years of 2020, and before you know it, we'll be in 2021, and we want to accomplish what God has ordained for us to accomplish, you understand, this year. So we've been focusing out of John 5, I mean, since last year, about bearing fruit. And so let's look at the scripture carefully. In John 5, glory be to God. He says, after this, we're going to start with verse 1. After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there at Jerusalem by the sheep market, a pool, I apologize to you, John 15. You know, pastor's on the wrong scripture. That's okay. John 15. It says, I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now you are clean through the word, which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself except it abide in the vine, no more can ye except you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the husband, you are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me you can do nothing. Whew, glory be to God. You see, we're destined to bear fruit. Glory be to God. And fruit that is visible on this earth. It comes from clinging to the vine. And this vine is the gospel. This vine is the word of God. We were talking recently that this word is the most needful thing we have. And in these next 6 months, it has to be. Look at verse 16 in John 15, 16. He says, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you. In other words, separate you, that you should go forth and bring forth fruit. What's the separation? The word of God. And that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever you shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it to you. I like the Passion Translation of this. The Passion Translation. It's you didn't choose me, but I chosen and commissioned you to go into the world to bear fruit. Now just stop in a moment. He's commissioned you. We're going to talk about that a little later. He's commissioned you. And your fruit will last because whatever you ask of my Father for my sake, he will give it to you. See, our fruit is supposed to last. Woo, glory be to God. Hallelujah. But notice he's chosen and commissioned you. That means he's giving you marching orders. He's giving you direction. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Matter of fact, let's look at some. Let's walk through this a moment, all right? The word in you is the most powerful thing that you have. And when you're hooked with the vine, woo, glory. Things change for you. Let's look at Psalm 75. Because we're talking about, what about these next 6 months? You can't undo the last 6 months, but you sure can change. You sure can have an effect on the next ones. Look at Psalm 75, verse 5 to 7. He says, lift up not your horn on high, speak not with a stiff neck, for promotion cometh neither from the east nor from the west, nor from the south, but God is the judge. He putteth down one and setteth up another. Now let's look at this really carefully here. See, promotion is part of your commission, and promotion comes to the, notice what it says here. Promotion, there's two things. Promotion comes to the humble, and the second thing, promotion comes only from the north. Look at the scripture. It says, for promotion neither come from the east nor the west nor the south. Well, what do you mean the north? It's vertical. That's what it is. That's where God resides. That's where our promotion comes from. That's where our increase comes from. You understand? He's commissioned us. And so, and the reason we experience promotion is to display God's goodness and to do kingdom's business, to supernaturally break worldly barriers. He's placed you to break down some worldly barriers, some world barriers, some religious barriers. That's what you're here for. Glory be to God. Just like Jesus. Look at 2 Corinthians 5:20. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians 5:20. 2 Corinthians 5:20. Let's get to that scripture right there. He says, "Now we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God did beseech you by us. We pray you in Christ's stead, be ye reconciled to God." Now notice he says we're ambassadors. And we talked about this being an ambassador, a true representative. Glory be to God. Let's look at another translation of this. We'll look at the message. It says, we're Christ's representatives. God uses us to persuade men and women to drop their differences and enter into God's work of making things right between them. We are speaking for Christ himself now. Become friends with God. He's already a friend with you. Let's go back and look at this again. You understand? We're ambassadors. Come on, say it with me. I'm an ambassador. Look what he says. We're Christ's representatives. We represent the kingdom of God. God uses us to persuade men and women to drop their differences and enter into God's word of making things right between them. See, God wants, he uses you to be an influence. He uses you to persuade. That's why many of you have changed. I just love how many years I've been saved and how God has transformed me and purged me. You understand? That if people meet, not only me, but if people meet you now, they couldn't even almost recognize you because he's purged you, because he needs you to represent him. Glory be to God. You're representing God. Ooh, we're Christ's representative. And we're here to persuade men and women to drop their differences and enter into the kingdom of God. Glory be to God. We're speaking for Christ. Glory be to God. I'm ministering to many of you today. We represent Christ. That's why we make changes. See, he's already a friend with you, but he wants you now to have other people to become friends with God. Glory be to God. You understand? He's using you. Now, I may seem I'm a little off, but I'm so excited about this, because if you want to look at your next 6 months, you got to let this word change you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Look at Ephesians 5:1. Ephesians 5:1. And I'm just going to read from the Amplified. Therefore, be imitators of God, copy him, and follow his example. As well-beloved children, imitate their father. So our job is to imitate God. Our job is, we follow Christ, we're following God. You understand? So we'll be imitators of him. You see, we need to look how the chief ambassador, you understand? Jesus was the chief ambassador for Christ. You understand? It's time now for supernatural to become natural in your life. It's time for that right now, that you walk in the supernatural. See, we are made in the image of God. And we are imitators of our Father, and we cannot accept a victim mindset. We're not a victim. Glory be to God. We can't accept a victim mindset. I don't care what you've gone through, you are not a victim. And you can't accept that victim mindset in the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. So I want to walk us through a story. You know, I want to walk us through just looking at our ambassador. Because if we see how he is, we'll learn how we are. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. If we see how he is, we learn how we walk in this ambassadorship. So turn to John 4, and we're going to look at verses 3-8. John 4, open up your Bible. Glory be to God. That's what we got it for. Glory be to God. John 4, glory be to God. When you have it, say amen. Come on, there's no rush in this. I know you've already, yesterday, you celebrated the American Independence Day. Glory be to God, but our independence came at the cross. So you may be filled with the hamburgers and hot dogs and steaks and ribs, whatever you enjoyed yourself with. You understand? Celebrating that. And there's nothing wrong with celebrating that because we are Americans, all right? Praise God. But today we're celebrating the true independence, that true independence that came at the cross. So let's look at John 4. Let's look at our chief ambassador. Then said the, we'll look at Jesus. He left Judea and departed again into Galilee. And he must needs go through Samaria. Then cometh he to a city of Samaria, which is called Sychar, near the parcel of ground that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Now Jacob's well was there. Jesus, therefore, being wearied with his journey, sat thus on the well, and it was about the sixth hour. Then cometh the woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus said unto her, give me to drink, for his disciples had gone away into the city to buy meat. Now let's talk a minute for a moment so we understand the thrust of this story. You understand? You know what's good about the Bible? You understand? We get the behind the scenes look at things. Glory be to God. We see things, you understand, that maybe at that moment the others didn't see. Because of that anointed author's writing, we see it. Now, Samaria was where the Samaritans lived, and they were hated by the Jews. There was a religious difference, a cultural, racial difference. They were a mixture of cultures. So Jesus would go. So Jews, instead of, if they had to go from Judea, you understand, to Jerusalem, you understand, they would go 3 to 5 days out of the way. You understand? 3 or 4 out of the way, just so they didn't have to go through Samaria. You understand? Matter of fact, the Samaritans to the Jews were considered half-breeds. You understand? Dogs, not worthy of honor. You know, it'll give you a more natural way. It's like for you to get home, you understand, if you go through the hood or the worst section of town, you'd get there in 20 minutes, but it's better to go around the expressway and save an hour. You understand? You understand? You know, because I don't want to go through that area. That area is not, that's not a good area. But see, Jesus's influence had affected the disciples. Are you with me? Look, if you look at verse 8, it says, now he's talking to them. He said, for his disciples had gone away unto the city to buy meat. So his impact, by them clinging to the vine, all of a sudden now they're going into Samaria to buy meat. They would never have done that if they weren't hooked with Jesus. Glory. When you get hooked with Jesus, it just changes you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You understand? It just changes you around. Come on. We're following the chief ambassador. Come on. Say that with me. I'm following. I'm imitating the chief ambassador. You're going to get something out of this today. Glory be to God. Come on. Let's go to John. Let's continue this story with John. We'll look at John 4, verse 9-14. Let's continue this story. All right. Then said the woman of Samaria unto him, and you have to understand, Jesus goes to the well with a mission. He had a mission. You know, remember we just talked about promotion. Sometimes you get promotions in the natural, you get this new job, but you've really been commissioned. You've been sent there. You understand? He's the one that determines. He's the one that determines who goes and who doesn't, who receives favor and who doesn't. But he promoted you. He put you in a better building. You've been living in the heart of the city, not in good places, and he put you in a better location. He commissioned you. He promoted you. It wasn't something you did. It was something he did. You understand? So here he is, he has a mission, and he goes to this well, and he's sitting at this well, and they're on a commission. Glory be to God. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, I read in verse 9, how is it that thou, being a Jew, ask drink of me, which am a woman of Samaria? for the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans. Jesus answered and said unto her, if thou knewest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, give me the drink, thou wouldn't have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. The woman said unto him, sir, there's nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. From whence thou hast that living water? And art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us the well, and drank himself thereof, and his children, and his cattle? Jesus answered and said unto her, whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up in everlasting life. Ooh, see, Jesus was offering this rejected woman, divided by where she lived, her culture, her religion, you understand? And even her race, because the Samaritans were considered mixed breeds, and even the cultural differences, an opportunity to be one with God. He was giving her an opportunity to be one with God, to become friend with God. Glory be to God. See, Jesus knew something that we have to know. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Jesus knew, I'm looking at Acts 17, verse 16. Come on. Acts 17, verse 16. Come on, let's get there. Acts 17, verse 16. When you get there, say amen. There we go. Acts 17, verse 16. I'm pulling it out of my Bible. And Acts 17, verse 26. And he says, and hath made of one blood all nations of men for to dwell on all the face of the earth, and hath determined the times before appointed and the bounds of their habitation. You know what the scripture is saying? Jesus knew there was only one race with the same blood. See, color is not a race. See, we are one race with many different skin pigmentations. See, and if you read, if you look at Acts 17, 26, it says, he sets the boundaries of people and nations determining the appointed time in history. He has a lot to do with you being here at this moment. But Jesus knew there was only one race. And it came with the same blood out of Adam. Now there's two distinctions. There's those who are saved and those who are not. And that's the only way God sees it. See, color is not a race to God. It's only been a race because of what man has determined. Glory be to God. You understand? See, Jesus knew, and because he was sent here, he knew the message of reconciliation. Now come on, I'm talking, we're following an ambassador. God's promoting you. He's putting you in different places. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And if we look at 2 Corinthians 5:19, let me take my time with this. 2 Corinthians 5:19. And I'm pulling it out of my Bible. 2 Corinthians 5:19. Come on, say this with me. I am an ambassador. I imitate my father. I follow his plan for my life. 2 Corinthians 5:19. Look what he says here. He says, to wit, that God was in Christ, reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespasses unto them, and hath committed unto us the word of reconciliation. The word reconcile means to restore people back to God. That can only happen through Jesus Christ. And here was Jesus being an example for us that, you know, many times God has placed you in situations so you can restore people back to God. Many times you're getting irritated because people are coming after you because they're showing some natural things. There's some facts that are true, but you've been sent there to reconcile people to God. That's what you've been there. Probably the people that irritate you the most. It could be because of race or other issues. You understand? God has put you there so you can reconcile. restore people back to God, because the people in the world need God. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. It didn't say for God so loved the saints. It said that God so loved the world. But he sent ambassadors, representatives. Glory. Are you representing him well? Glory be to God. To restore people back to Christ. Glory be to God. And that's what you've been. You're a part of this. I don't care if it's in your neighborhood. I don't care if it's on a job. I don't care where you're at. It doesn't matter what field you're in. If you're a born-again believer, you understand God has commissioned you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You know, for that, he's commissioned you to that. You know, many times I see people who get promoted, that they'll get a job like they don't deserve. I mean, and they pay them extremely well. And then the first time trouble comes, they're ready to quit the job. First time somebody disagree with you. First time somebody lie on you. First time somebody come up against you. You understand? You know, you almost lose it, not remembering what your purpose is there. He didn't send you there for a check. You understand? He didn't even send you for the title. He sent you there, you understand, to represent him. Because there, I have no doubt there's people there who need to be reconciled to God. Some of your neighbors need to be reconciled to God. Glory be to God. You got to look at this from the truth, not from facts. See, the world deals with facts. We deal with truth. Because if you look at the facts, you understand those facts are based on circumstances, experiences. And if you get caught up in the circumstances, experiences, you're going to miss God, because God only deals with the truth. And we are people who deal only and totally with the truth. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Come on, let's go back to our story. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Matter of fact, let's look at another translation, 2 Corinthians 5:19. For God was in Christ, reconciling the world to himself, no longer counting people's sins against them. And he gave us the wonderful message of reconciliation. Notice what he gave you, the wonderful message. It's the most powerful message you have. Glory be to God. Some people say, so many people are searching for the fivefold ministry to be a prophet, an apostle, and they're not even walking in the wonderful message of reconciliation. I believe as you walk in that message, you'll be able to see your calling. That's why so many people are off base with their calling. Glory, if the shoe don't fit, don't wear it. But that's why you're having struggles with it, because you haven't received this wonderful message of reconciliation. You haven't been walking in that wonderful message of reconciliation. Restoring. Woo, thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Tell him, you know, here in this situation, you understand, the woman's sins did not have an effect on Jesus. This woman that we're dealing with, this woman at the well. And remember, I'm having us look at him as we imitate Jesus. Woo, glory be to God. We're going to see promotion like we've never seen before. You know, he says the greatest, you know, love cannot fail. And I'm talking here, when you talk about the ministry of reconciliation, you're talking about love. Let's go back to John 4. And let's go to verses 15 to 19. We stopped at 14. Look what it says here. The woman said unto him, talking to Jesus, sir, give me this water that I thirst not. Because he told her, I got some water that you'll never thirst. We read that in 14. You ain't never going to thirst. Neither come hither to draw. And Jesus said unto her, go call thy husband and come hither. The woman answered and said, I have no husband. Jesus said unto her, thou hast said well. I have no husband. For thou hast five husbands. And he whom thou hast is not thy husband. And in that saidest thou truly. The woman said unto him, sir, I perceive that thou art a prophet. Look at the woman's sins. Her background did not deter Christ from coming after her, just like he came after you. He ignored her mixed race. He ignored the mixed race. He ignored that the Jews thought her as a dog. He ignored her sins. He came after her. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You understand? He wasn't moved by what the world's standards were. He wasn't moved by the facts. Look at Ephesians 1 and it's verse 23. Ephesians 1, 23. Let me read it out of the King James, and we're going to look at the Message translation of this. All right? We're going to look at the Message translation of this, but let me read it out of the King James first. Notice what it says here, Ephesians 1, 23. It says, which is his body, the fullness of him that filleth all in all. It's talking about Christ, which is his body. The fullness of him that what filleth all in all. Now, I want you to look at this translation of this, of the Message translation. Look what it says. It says the church, you see, is not peripheral to the world. The world is peripheral to the church. The church is Christ's body, in which he speaks and acts, by which he fills everything with his presence. See, you know, this scripture is saying the church should not be, and we're the church, should not be revolving around the world, watching what they do and following it. No, the world should be revolving around the church. They should be following what we're doing. They should be looking at how what we are doing instead of us looking at what they are doing and then making a determination whether we will follow it. You understand? Remember, the world should be revolving around you. You understand? Your unsaved loved ones need to be revolving around you. Those people on the job in the neighborhoods need to be revolving around you, not what they're doing. You don't revolve around them. You understand? Because we're filled with his presence. We're filled with his anointing. We're filled with his word. We have the Holy Spirit in us who gives us wisdom and guidance. We have a teacher in us. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Remember, we look at 2 Corinthians 5:19 again. Glory be to God. Let's look at it again. 2 Corinthians 5:19. Remember who we are. We're ambassadors. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We're ambassadors. Glory be to God. Look at 2 Corinthians 5:19. It says, to wit that God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespasses unto them, and have committed unto us the word of reconciliation. He's called you to be involved in the ministry of reconciliation. He's called you to be involved into what's going on in the world, but you're going to deal with it with the truth. He's commissioned you, glory be to God, that you understand, to effect a change. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Come on. Stop telling me you don't think you're called. You are called. You are anointed. Come on, get this word in you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Come on, let's even take it a little further. Come on here. I'm talking about your purpose. I'm talking about you bearing fruit. This is the type of fruit God wants you to bear. Because you have to transform to be able to bear this fruit. You have to walk about in the love and the fruit of the Spirit. And that's what God is working on. He wants people to see that. He wants to see the kindness. He wants to see the love. He wants to see the unforgiveness. These are the things people are going to see, and it's going to make your message clearer. It's going to make your message more sound. Glory be to God, because that's where Jesus was at. Glory be to God. Look at Job 22. And let's look at verse 29. I believe it's 19. I apologize. He says, when men are cast down, then thou shalt say there's a lifting up, and he shall save the humble person. Glory be to God. You know, before you were born again and understood your identities in Christ, you were cast down. Some of you didn't even think right of yourself. You had so many people that were putting you down. You understand? You had so many issues. But Jesus elevated just like Jesus elevated the woman at the well and lifted her out of shame, condemnation, and unrighteousness, that's what he did for you. You understand? It saved, you understand? There's a lifting up and it's humble. You became humble. When you came to Christ, nobody had pride. You dropped everything. Because if you had pride, you couldn't receive it. You understand? This is deeper than saying, just saying a confession for Jesus. This is a change of the heart. And where one time you could be prideful, you understand, be all about you. When you accept Christ, you have to humble yourself to do it because you're making him Lord. But there's a lifting up, and that's what ministry, that's what you are as ambassador. You're called to lift people up, to lift them out of their situation. I'm talking these next 6 months. If you don't see what's going on in the world, you understand, we can do a deep teaching on the last days, and I know you've heard these things, but you got to recognize where you are, what your purpose is. Well, you know, as God blesses you, he still has an expectation from you to represent him. Glory be to God. Because some of us come out of some deep, deep, dark places. I know I have. If you ever been on drugs, you ever been hurt and abused, you ever had no one who loved you, your father rejected your mother, let me tell you, you're cast down. They'll take everything. You confront, but there's a cast down. But there's a lifting up. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. There's a lifting up. Come on, let's go back to John. Come on, let's go back to this woman. All right, let's go back to this woman with the woman at the well. And we're going to look at John 4, 25 to 30. Come on, let's look at this. The woman said unto him, I skipped about the part where she worshiped, but you need to spend time in this scripture. Because this is the answer. Some of these, God gives us spiritual answers to what's going on in the world. Remember, I tell you, you need to look at the biblical solutions to what the facts are saying. So I spent time looking at the biblical solutions to what's going on around here, because I want to follow the truth, not facts. I don't want to follow my emotions. I don't want to follow my experiences. You understand? I might have been, before I was born again, I might have been a revolutionary. I might have saw things differently. But once I get born again, I got to see it the kingdom way. Sometimes you have to leave your experiences aside. The negative, because sometimes you have to leave your fear, you always have to leave your feelings and emotions aside so you can see it God way. How can you help people, you understand, help those who you love if you're siding with the enemy, if you're siding with your emotions or feelings? Because that's where the enemy works from. But in John 4, let's look at verse 25 to 30. The woman said unto him, they say unto Jesus, you understand, I know that the Messiah cometh, which is called Christ. When he is come, he will tell us all things. And Jesus said unto her, I speak unto thee, am he. Now stop at the moment. He told her that he was the Christ. I mean, he didn't share that a lot. He shared it with his 12 disciples and they couldn't comprehend it. But he tells her, I'm the Christ. And upon this came his disciples and marveled that he talked with the woman. Yet no man, what seekest thou, or why talkest with her? And the only reason they marveled, because it wasn't customary that a rabboni or rabbi would be sitting there talking to a woman. The woman then left her water pot, went her way into the city, and said to the men, come and see a man which told me all the things that I ever did. Is not this the Christ? Then they went into the city, and they came unto her. And when you read the rest of the scripture, because we don't have time for it right at this moment, we may visit this again next week. When you understand that the Samaritans, the ones that are hated, the ones that were called dogs, the ones that were a mixed race, you understand, Jesus stayed in that Samaria for 2 extra days with the disciples, ministering to them. Glory be to God. I mean, healing. He's ministering to them. They are hungry for the word because he walked in that ministry. Sometimes people who have talked against you, bit against you, backstab you, will end up calling you. I had a situation once. I was working on a job, and this person, I mean, she was my supervisor, just hounded me. And I'm sure it was a mixture of racial and things and people. And, you know, I had to keep praying for her. I remember one time the Lord told me, give her a birthday card. I gave her a birthday card. You know, she brought it back to me and said, well, I don't think it's right for you to give me birthday cards with her. But I know the Lord told me. And then nothing. It was just a good birthday card, happy birthday. But one day she came into my office and tears were in her eyes. She said, I know you're different. I don't know this about, I know you're different, but I have a relative. She was someone close to her, brother or sister. I don't remember at the time. They were dying or were in a car accident. Will you pray for them? I really need you to pray for them because I believe that God hears your prayers. Now, I've never been up there running a Bible study, never did anything of that nature. But let me tell you, we prayed, glory be to God. There was a transformation, glory be to God. Hallelujah. You understand? And, you know, and gave me a door opportunity to share with her about Christ and who he is. You understand? Sometimes we may have to, you know, much is given, much is required. Every promotion you get, there's going to be more required of you to walk in the spirit and walk in the anointing and walk under God. To allow the fruit of the spirit. You want, a lot of us want these promotions, but we're not willing to submit to where God's plan for our life. Because he doesn't promote you or put you in a situation. Yet, to me, a promotion is coming around from a promotion, not just a career, coming out of just a cheap apartment filled with roaches to your own place, free. You understand what I'm saying? I mean, a beautiful place that you, something you dreamed about or something you want, and you know you're moving to another level. He has, it's more than just that place. It's more than just the new car. You understand? It's where that car will take you, what it would expose for you. You got to see the bigger picture. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And see, the disciples were learning this bigger picture because they were hanging with Christ. Otherwise, they wouldn't have been in the city. Otherwise, they would have rebuked him for being there. There was a time they would have done it. But the more they got with him, and the more you get with the word, the more be able to follow Christ. The world needs you. The devil triumphs when believers are silent. We have a voice, and we have action that can produce so many things. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. See, we need to show the world how we deal with division, sickness, and lack, and disease. See, they need to see our faith in God's word. And I'm talking to someone here today. I mean, you just need to trust God's word. You got to really trust. But Pastor, I've been through a lot. The Bible says, you know, I done made so many mistakes. But the Bible says, when you fall, you shall arise. When you sit in darkness, God will be a light unto you. He doesn't look at your fallings. He looks at you getting up. That's how he looks at you. Stop complaining about your coworkers. Stop complaining about the racial differences on this. You know, we've been complaining about the same thing for so many. Stop complaining and find out what the truth says and follow the truth. You know, when you listen to the world, whether it's CNN, MSNBC, Fox Network, or any other network that's just drama, they're going to dramatize what they want you to hear. They're going to talk about all the deaths of COVID-19. Never about those who are healed or whole. And I'm not saying they don't do that, but see, the world builds on fear. They build on, if we pass this law, it'll make a change in a person, when really a person's heart has to change concerning some of these laws. And only God can change a heart. And I'm not against anything that's passed or laws that's going to be, I see laws that are going to be changing and things that will be going. Praise God for that. But I got to follow the truth. His word is the truth. See, we deal with truth, not facts. You understand? Because facts can never override truth, but truth can always override facts. And truth has to have faith. It has to have a fully persuaded what God said he will perform. So you got to believe you deserve promotion for promotion to come to you. Well, I don't deserve it because of who I am in the natural. I deserve it for who I am in Christ. I deserve a better job, a better place to live because of who I am in Christ. So I follow. So if I'll follow a seed time and harvest. If I want people to love me, I'm going to love them. I'm going to sow a seed of love. If I want people to be kind to me, I'm going to sow kind. Even if they aren't kind, I'm going to sow that seed. Because guess what? His word never fails. Glory be to God. His word never fails. Just like that woman at the well who came at the well at 12 o'clock only because she didn't want to be ridiculed. Even her own kind talked about it. Even her own kind ripped her apart. That's why she came at 12, in the heat of the sun. She comes at 12 o'clock, when normally people come when it's cool. And she's there in the heat, so she doesn't have to talk to nobody. So people don't have to talk about her. And who does she meet? Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Woo! She met who? Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Sometimes you forget who you are. Sometimes we do. We forget who we are. Glory be to God. Turn to Matthew 5:13. I'm talking about bearing fruit, but I'm talking about you walking in your ambassadorship. I'm talking about reconciling the world to God. All of you have this calling on you. All of you have this ministry. And sometimes people ask me, well, you know, I believe a call. What should I be working on? Well, work on the ministry of reconciliation. Be a light in a dark place. I like Matthew 5, verse 13 to 15. It says, you are the salt of the earth. But if the salt have lost its savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is thenceforth good for nothing but to be cast out and to be trodden up under foot of men. You are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under the bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Now, you've heard this scripture a lot. Let's look at another translation of this, the New Living. It says, you are the salt of the earth, but what good is salt if it has lost its flavor? Can you make it salty again? It will be thrown out and trampled underfoot as worthless. So let's just stop. You are the salt of the earth. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Say that with me. I'm the salt of the earth. Glory. Now, those of you on a job, you understand? The job is, you're having some difficulty on that job. Just say that with me. I'm the salt of the earth. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm the salt of the earth. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Woo. That just gets me excited. Come on, say that again. I'm the salt of the earth. Come on, say it again. I'm the salt of the earth. I can't hear you. I'm the salt of the earth. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So let's look at it further. Come on, let's take it even further. It says it will be thrown out and trampled underfoot as worthless. So if you're not representing God the way you're supposed to represent him, if all of a sudden now you got caught up in the world and you're following them, you understand? You don't lost your flavor. You've lost your flavor. Glory be to God. We don't want to lose our flavor. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You understand? We don't. Look at the next verse. It says, you are the light of the world like a city on a hilltop that cannot be hidden. You don't even know why people are jealous of you and envious of you. You don't even know that people know you and you don't even know them because you're the light of the world like a city on a hilltop. They know who you are. You know, you go back there, I'm so-and-so. Yeah, I know who you are. You're the light of the world like a city on a hilltop. Look what it says in the next verse. And 4:15, no one lights a lamp and then puts it under a basket. Instead, a lamp is placed on a stand where it gives light to everyone in the house. And for some of you, you give light to your family. So stop complaining about them. Stop talking about them. You understand? And work on your ministry of reconciliation. Stop being unkind to them. Stop treating them the way they treat you. Treat them the way Christ treats you. You understand? You're an ambassador for Christ. You're commissioned. See, sometimes we need to stop preaching to our family and just live the life. They'll see it. Woo, glory be to God. They'll see who you are. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. They'll see who you are. And see, you say, Pastor, this is challenging with it. But see, you forget something. He says, Romans 8:31 says, what shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? Who can come up against you when you're following God? Who has the strength? Who has the mustard? Who can come up against you when you stand on what God says? No, you may not be liked. You may be talked about, but look who you are with God. You understand? Nothing. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. No one can win against us when we walk in truth. I'm talking about your ambassadorship. See, I'm talking about these next 6 months. Take the focus off of you and put the focus on him. When you put the focus on his word, you'll be looking at souls. It's just all of us. Some people say, well, I'm not an evangelist. We all are witnesses for him. We all have the ministry of reconciliation. And God is before us. As you go forth, I remember a friend of mine named Shockey. Shockey was from Australia. And Shockey, man, my God. You know, Shockey he just loved winning souls. So you'd be sitting in the restaurant. I remember one time we were sitting in the restaurant. It was Shockey, about 8 of us. And, all of a sudden the waiter came. Next thing you know, he done led the waiter to the Lord. Matter of fact, he went back to the back in the kitchen and his chef got saved. I mean, he had such a heart that he wasn't ashamed. He had this love in him that he would just share and listen to people and love. And he used to make some Christians uncomfortable. Some people get uncomfortable being around that. You understand? Because we forget who we are. and all my time with him, I think I've never seen him not witness to someone or share that didn't come to Christ. I mean, it just, and I had to learn that he just had a love, you understand, for that ministry. He just wanted people to be, come, I'm a friend with God, you can be a friend with God. And he would just share, just simplistic with it. And it was awesome to see, to see how God worked through him. But then God works through all. I'll never forget what he told somebody. Somebody said, I want to be evangelist like you. He said, you're already called. You already got a ministry. He said, I was doing this before the Holy Spirit promoted me to another level. But this is what I do. He said, this is who we are. I'll never forget when he said that. Hallelujah. I never forget that we have to recognize that we're here so others can know there's God, that there's a God. God blesses you, not as much for you. He wants you to experience what heaven is like on earth, but he's also blessing you so you can be a blessing to someone else. When's the last time you gave into someone else instead of always looking for them to give into you? When's the last time you gave a card, sent a card, even though these people have never sent you a card, never did it, but something inside of you say, give them a card. And they, you understand, and you get upset because maybe they didn't say thank you. Come on. There's a bigger picture. There's a truth. Glory be to God. Come on, let's close out with Isaiah 61. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Isaiah 61. You getting something out of this? Come on, we're going to imitate Christ. Glory be to God. We're not going to get caught up. You understand? We're not going to let what the world is doing allow us to make choices. We're going to make the choices, and the world's going to follow us. Hallelujah. Isaiah 60. And let's look at verse 1. And many of you know this scripture, because I believe there's, you know, I believe strongly that there's a move of God. There's a lifting up. In Isaiah 60, verse 1, he says, arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen unto thee. And I like the amplified version of this. I believe I have the amplified version of this. Come on, show it to me. There you go. He says, arise from the depression and prostration in which circumstances have kept you. Rise to a new life. Shine, be radiant with the glory of the Lord, for your light has come and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Come on, let's look at that. Arise from the depression, prostration in which circumstances have kept you. There is presently a change these next 6 months, a shifting and a lifting up taking place right now. And we need to arise out of the circumstances that have kept you bound. You need to rise to a new life. You need to rise out of the poverty, rise out of not having enough, rise in how people treated you. We need to arise. You understand? And we need to shine. Glory for your light has come, and your light is the Lord. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you, Father, that we arise today in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Father, that we're going to move to another level in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father, for that right now. There's a change, there's a shift and a lifting up. See, some of you want the shift of the ministry, but you don't want the consequences of changing. You want the title, but you don't want to walk in it as Jesus walked in it. And sometimes you can tell the people by their fruit whether the title actually fits or they've jumped out ahead. Because many of us in the world runs after titles and degrees. You understand? Because it makes them appear to be something. God comes after your heart. And I'm talking to those of you here today. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You understand? I'm talking to you today. It's time to arise. It's time to walk in your calling. It's a time for you these next 6 months to make a determination. They will be 100 times better than the last 6 months. That's all you got to believe, 100 times better than the last 6 months. I didn't say 30. I didn't say 60. 100 times better. Come on. Are you with me here today? Are you here with me today on this? So why don't you say this with me? Make this confession of faith. Lord Jesus, I speak out of my heart. I've heard your word. I saw what you did with the woman at the well. And I thank you, Father. There was a time I was downtrodden. I was lower than low. And you lifted me up out of a dark place. But in the name of Jesus Christ, I'm not going back to my circumstances. I'm not going back to live through my old experiences. I'm arising today. I'm shining. I'm going to follow you. Forgive me if I focused too much on me and not enough on you. Forgive me if the word of God has not been the most needful thing that I have in my life. These next 6 months, I need your help. Open my eyes so I can see the bigger picture, the spiritual picture, so I can walk by faith and not by sight. In Jesus' name, amen. Woo, glory. I hope you, if you made that confession, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Give a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Come on, say that with me. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Woo, works. Come on, give a shout of hallelujah. Glory be to God. Woo, I'm just slap happy. Glory be to God. I pray you got something out of this message today. Wasn't a long message, but it's a truthful one. And Jesus is our example. See, when you look at him, you'll know how to deal with anything that comes up in the world. You understand? Anything that comes up with the world, you know how to deal with them. Glory be to God. If you have a testimony and you like to share with us, you know, some of your testimony, you know, we appreciate people who've been, I thank those of you who have been sending us your testimony, telling us what God has done in your life or telling us what this broadcast has done in your life. All you have to do is contact us at wcccw.org on our contact page, or you could just email us. If you're looking at the screen, you can see our email address. Just contact us and let us know what this broadcast is doing for you. But time right now is for, right now, it's offering time. Hallelujah. Offering time. You get a chance to worship God with your giving. Because that's all an offering is giving something that's, you understand, that is important to you, to him. That was the difference between Cain and Abel. You know, one gave the best, the other just gave just what they felt like. But one gave their best. All God asks you to do is give your best right at this time. That's what he asked of you. And don't tell me because, you know, I love people who say, well, you know, I'm not able to give, you know, because we're not in a building or something of that nature. I thank all of you who have been sowing seed. You understand? I thank all of you who've been sowing seed. Those of you who mail it, those of you who sow it, God honors that. That's part of seed time and harvest. That's part of your future. That's part of obeying the truth, not what you're dealing with. So I pray today that you'll listen to the Holy Spirit let me tell you, you give your best. Glory be to God. Whether it's $20, $1,000, $5,000, or $2, or 50 cents, you give your best to the Lord. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So let's pray. And after I pray, I want you to take a time as the Minister Walt is ministering in song to ask the Lord what to sow. Glory be to God. If you look on our Facebook, you'll see that we have three different ways to sow. You can go on our webpage, hit donate, and it takes credit and debit cards, PayPal. You can do Cash App, or you can just mail it to us at P.O. Box 2587, Wilmington, Delaware, 19805. But now let's pray. Father, we thank you for the word. I thank you that just like Jesus, your people will imitate Christ. They will imitate God. We give today, not grudgingly or of necessity. No pressure was put upon us. We give because you have been so good to us. And we want to be givers, not takers. Givers, not only trying to receive. We want to give to you for all that you've done for us. Just this past week, things we don't even know that occurred. We're honored to be a giver into the kingdom. In Jesus' name, Amen. Glory be to God. Why don't you join Brother Walt as he ministers song? Glory be to God.
Amen. Glory to God. You know, let's lean on the great I Am today. Let's lean on the I Am this morning. The truth is, he's already fixed it. He's already taken care of it.
I am the creator. I am the maker.
Sorry about that, y'all. That's right. We're still leaning on the great I Am.
I am the creator, I am the maker of you.
We get it, y'all, we get it. Glory to God.
I am the maker of the universe. I am the one who spoke into nothing and all creation birthed. I am he who has all power in my hands.
This is the Lord speaking.
And if you believe on my word, you can stand. Cause I am healer, mender of broken hearts. Alpha Omega, your destiny and where you start. I am the one who does impossible things. That's who I am. Just let me be who I am to you. That's who I am. Just let me be who I am for you. I am the one who sees the need and always provides. I am the one whose name is a tower where you can run and hide. I am he who has all power in my hands.
Yes.
If you believe on my word, you can stand. Cause I am healer, mender. Yes, I am. God says, I'm Alpha Omega, your destiny and where you start. I am the one who does impossible things. Yes, that's who I am. Just let me be who I am for you. God says this, if there's a need, you say. When you are sick, depend on the overwhelmed in the moment right now, but can't see your way. You gotta believe that's who I am.
That's who I am.
Just let me be who I am for you. The doctor says corona, but you say the lawyer says jail time. That's right, he's a just God.
He can fix it. Sometimes you can't see your way and you're losing your mind, but He can fix it. You gotta believe. Just let Him be the I am. You gotta believe He's the I am, you say. Just let me fix it. Hear the word of the Lord. Just let me fix it. Yeah. That's who I am. Just let me be who I am for you. That's who I am. Just let me be who I am for you.
Praise God. Thank you, Minister Walt. Glory be to God. That's who I am. Glory be to God, an ambassador for Him. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. You know, before we close with our announcements, glory be to God, I just want to thank you for being a part of this ministry. Glory be to God. We're excited. You know, in a few weeks, we're believing to be back in a location. You understand? Where we get a little touchy and feel, but you understand? But we will always be on live. Hallelujah. And those times are coming. So why don't you listen to our announcements and we'll close out. Don't leave right now. Why don't you listen? Glory God, from Sister Carmen.
All right. Well, we do have some announcements that we want to share. So we definitely want to remind all of our teens and youth and our parents that right after service, so at 11:30, we will have our teen and youth ministry. So make sure you get everyone prepared for that. There is a Zoom invite for that. So make sure you go to our page to make sure that you know how to sign in. So again, get your youth and teen ready for that. Also want to remind everyone, every Sunday, of course, we have our 10 a.m. service, right? So just like you signed in today, you'll do that next Sunday as well and invite friends and family. Every Tuesday, we have our corporate prayer. You can actually go out to our webpage just to find out about that, how you would sign on. But it starts at 12:30 and it's live. And then every Wednesday, we have mid-morning prayer. So that's from 6 a.m. till about 6:15. There is a sign-in number. It's 717-275-8941. Then you're going to enter a code, 9252-738. And I know I didn't say get a pen or pencil to write it down because I want you to go to our webpage to find out the exact call-in number and access code that I just gave you. Every Thursday morning, we have our online Deeper Life Bible study that starts at 7 p.m. That's live as well. Technology is great, isn't it? Because we are still able to provide all of these services and they are live. So make sure you go out to our webpage and find out about how do I access these. So definitely if you have emails that you want to send to us or you want to reach out and contact us, make sure that you go out to our page, wcccw.org. Because all of our information in terms of services, times, access codes, or numbers that you need, it's on our webpage. And then also there's a contact page. If you need anything in terms of food, or if you need prayer, or if you need someone to contact you because you just want to talk to someone, go out to wcccw.org and contact us. Okay? So have a great day. No, have a blessed day. Amen. Thank you.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Sister Carmen. Glory be to God. You know, make sure if you have young people between the ages of 6, 5 to 17, this is opportunity for them to come into our youth ministry. If you go on our webpage or it may be even on our Facebook page, you can definitely get on with your kids. You should make it a practice. You know, parents, we're going to be held accountable for training up our kids in the ways of the Lord. You know, as a church, our job is to assist you. That's what we're doing. We're assisting you. And I'm telling you, they're having a great time. I've watched it a few times. They're having a ball learning about Christ and learning of who they are in Christ. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. It could be the best 30 or 40 minutes of that child's week, especially with what's going on in the world. Glory be to God. So take opportunity. They prayed. The teachers have prayed. They're hearing from God and they're giving a message. I'm telling you, that is relevant for our young people today. Quite relevant. Glory be to God. Take heed to all those announcements. Glory be to God. Feel free to contact us. If you or anyone are going through sickness or disease, You understand? Why don't you contact us? We want to keep you in prayer. Or if you have a lack of food, just let us know. We want to assist you in any way. We have people in our church, have ministries, and we know ministries that assist you in many different areas. We love you. We thank God for you. You understand? I hope you were blessed today. Watch the message again. You may have heard it and had some mixed feelings. Sit down and sit to the watch the message again. Go through the scriptures. Study to show thyself approved. Glory be to God. Take your time. Don't go by quick hearing. Go by thorough hearing, because faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And sometimes you have to hear it over and over again. So that's why if you look at our webpage, all our messages are there. If you watch our Thursday night Bible study, you can get copies of our outline, glory be to God, that you can take and study to show thyself approved. We love you. We thank God for you. Glory be to God. This is going to be an awesome week. Awesome week for you. Say this with me. I am blessed and highly favored. I am righteous, never forsaken. My seed will never beg bread. That's why I can boldly say Satan is defeated. Darkness is dispelled totally from my life because Jesus Christ is Lord of my life. You have a blessed and prosperous day. And remember, Jesus Christ is absolutely Lord. God bless you. Have a great week.